Hello student, this is Purushottam Vishwakarma and today our topic is Reach for the Top Part 1 Santosh Yadav. Today we are going to talk about Santosh Yadav, a girl who had 5 brothers. She was the 6th child in the family of 5 brothers. She was a lonely girl. How she survived, where usually girls were not welcomed, though they were not considered as a curse, but the girls were not generally welcomed. How she survived and how she became the only woman who have scaled the Mount Everest twice. After that, there are many women, but initially she was the only one who scaled Mount Everest twice. So let's continue. The only woman in the world who has scaled Mount Everest twice was born in a society where the birth of a son was regarded as a blessing. She was born in a family where the birth of a son was regarded as a blessing. The family members thought the son is a blessing and the daughter is a burden. Though her family members did not believe in curse, but surely they did not like a girl child. Though she was not considered as a curse, and a daughter, though not considered a curse, was not generally welcome. She was not welcome. A girl in the family was not generally welcomed. When her mother was expecting Santosh, when she was in the womb of her mother, when her mother was expecting her, she was in the womb, she was not born yet, a traveling holy man giving her his blessing. So there came a traveling holy man, a saint, who gave him blessing. What was the blessing given? Usually these saint think that all of them want a son. So they are very good at it. They see your face and imagine what you think. Guess after your facial expression. And accordingly, they bless you. This happened. She was also blessed because he thought they wanted a son. He blessed them with a son, giving her his blessing. Assume that she wanted a son, so he gave him the blessing. That woman, Santosh's mother, was in the family. When she was given the blessing of her son, surprisingly, Santosh's grandmother, but to everyone's surprise, the unborn child's grandmother, who was standing close by, Santosh's grandmother, who was standing close by, nearby, told him that they did not want a son. Grandmother told the holy man, the saint, that they did not want a son. They wanted a girl. The holy man was also surprised. At this point, the holy man was also surprised because he assumed that they wanted a son. Nevertheless, he gave this requested blessing. Nevertheless, in spite of it, he gave the requested blessing. You want a son? Tathastu. No, you don't want a son? A daughter? tathastu. Like they say. And as destiny would have it, surely whatever he said, whatever the holy man said, it was in the destiny of Santosh Yadav. She was in the womb of her mother. And the words came true. The blessing seemed to work. Santosh was born the sixth child in the family with five sons. As I told you, she was the sixth child. And earlier, she has five brothers elder to her. A sister to five brothers. She was born in the small village of Juniawas of Rewari district in Haryana. She was born in the small town, small village of Haryana. In Haryana, there is Rewari district, and in Rewari district, there is a village Juniawas. The girl was given the name Santosh. And what was the name she was given? The name she was given was Santosh, that means contentment, satisfied. But Santosh was not always content with her place in a traditional way of life. Though her name was Santosh, but she was not satisfied with her name. She was not satisfied with the life, traditional life she was forced to live. She always tried to live life according to her own will, as per her own choice. She began living life on her own terms from the start. From the very start, she started living her life as per her wish. From the start, where other girls wore traditional dresses, while other girls were wearing traditional dresses, salwar, kurta, she was wearing shorts. So she showed from the beginning itself that she was not going to listen to anybody. She was not going to follow. She was not going to follow anybody's demand. She will live life as per her own choice. Looking back, she says now, when she remembers her old days, looking back, she says now, in the interview, she says, from the very beginning, I was quite determined. She says that, since starting, she was quite determined that if I choose a correct and rational path, if she had chosen a correct path, if her cause was true, if she was right in her path, the others around me had to change, not me. Then the opinion of people around her should change, not her opinion. If you are right, then people should change, not you. Santosh's parents were affluent landowners. The parents were well-to-do family. They had money, plenty of money. They were well-to-do, well-off family, who could afford to send their children to the best schools, who could send her and other sons to the best schools in the locality, even of the capital, that is New Delhi. And you must know, Haryana and Delhi are neighboring places. New Delhi, which was quite close by, but in line with the prevailing custom in the family, in accordance with what was the custom, girls were not allowed to go out of the village school. They were allowed to study only in the village school, that village elementary school, primary school. So they were not allowed to study any more out of that school, beyond that limit. And most of the girls at the age of 16 got married. So child marriage was prevailed. New Delhi, which was quite close by, but in the line with the prevailing custom that was continuously, they were following the same custom. Santosh had to make do with the local village school. She had to study in the local village school. So she decided to fight the system in her own quiet way when the right moment arrived. But she thought, she decided to disobey, to revolt. She waited till the right moment arrived. And the right moment came when she turned 16. And the right moment came when she was 16 years old. At 16, most of the girls in her village used to get married, as I told you. This was the custom in her village. Not only in her village at that time, it was a custom of India, child marriage. Most of the girls, even below the age of 16 years, got married because they were supposed to be a burden in the family. Santosh was also under pressure from her parents to do the same. She was also under pressure to do the same. Her parents forced her, pressurized her to get married as soon as possible because most of her contemporary girls, similar age group girls, her friends got married. A marriage as early as that was the last thing on her mind. But at that initial stage of life, at 16 years, to be a wife, to get married, was the last thing, least important thing for her. She threatened her parents that she would never marry. She threatened her parents. She got a chance. She was waiting for this moment when parents would say to get married, and she would threaten them, "No, I'm not going to get married if you are not going to give me proper education." She left home and got herself enrolled in a school in Delhi. She left home, went to Delhi, got herself enrolled in a school in Delhi. When her parents refused to pay for her education, at this point, parents got angry. "No, we cannot allow you to go to Delhi and study there." She informed them about her plans, how she was going to earn money and she was going to pay for her fees. She politely informed them of her plans to earn money by working part-time to pay for her school fees. Her parents then agreed to pay for her education. So ultimately, due to her determination, she was determined. So due to her determination, her parents had to agree. They agreed because they thought, if we are not going to pay, she would work part-time and that will be a same for us. We are well-to-do family, and ultimately they agreed to pay. Wishing always to study a bit more, it was her ambition to study a bit more, more and more. And with her father slowly getting used to her urge, soon her father started affection towards her, began to think that she would also study. For more education, Santosh passed the high school examinations. There in Delhi, she passed the high school examinations and went to Jaipur. Therefrom, she went to Jaipur and joined Maharani College, Jaipur. She joined Maharani College and got a room in Kasturba Hostel. She went to Jaipur, Rajasthan. She enrolled in Maharani College and then she got a room in Kasturba Hostel. Santosh remembers. Now she remembers how she developed attraction, temptation towards mountaineering. Kasturba Hostel faced the Aravali Hills. Just in front of Kasturba Hostel, there were the hills of Aravali. She used to look at the hills. She used to look at the people coming and going, and after going at the other side, disappearing. She was curious. Where were they going? They are going from here and ultimately disappearing. So one day she could not wait. She went to see. I used to watch villagers from my room. From her room, Aravali Hills were visible. She used to look at, going up the hill and suddenly vanishing after a while. They used to go there and suddenly vanished. After some time, vanished. One day I decided to check it out myself. To quench her curiosity, she decided to check it herself. She wanted to check it herself. I found nobody except a few mountaineers. So there, when she went there, she found nobody except a few mountaineers. There were mountaineers whose task was to do mountaineering, to climb the mountains. I asked if I could join them. And for the first time, she developed a temptation towards mountaineering. She asked them if she could join them. And to her surprise, it was a turning point that changed her entire life. This was the point when she was asked to join mountaineering. Her question was welcomed. Her wish was fulfilled. And they allowed her. What she asked? She asked if I could join them. If she could join them. To my pleasant surprise, as she has said, she was surprised. They answered in affirmative. Those people, those mountaineers who were at the point, at the hills of Aravali, where to quench her curiosity, one day she could not control her feelings. She went out, went to see, and saw nobody except few mountaineers. And those few mountaineers welcomed her. When she asked them if she could join them, they answered in affirmative. They answered, yes, you can join us. They answered in the affirmative. In direct narration, if yes is written, then we change into indirect narration like this. Answered in, replied in affirmative, in the affirmative. If no, then we say in the negative. And motivated me to take to climbing. And all of them, all the mountaineers available over there, motivated her to climb the mountains. And this was the time in the life of Santosh Yadav that she developed a feeling, a love towards mountaineering. Not only she developed a temptation, a feeling towards mountaineering, she became successful too. That is why we remember her even today. We feel proud to be Indian because she was also Indian who conquered Mount Everest twice. even after being a woman. Thank you very much.